here. Someone's in my fucking house. Oh, boys! Get them!
You want a brawl? Knock yourselves out.
Flanking!
Murder time.
You thieves! strength of the blade!
I'm hearing something to the left.
Rangers, this is Woodson. Looks like you're heading deeper into the lodge. Before you go on, let me give you the sit rep on what you'll find. first off, thanks for taking out the guards. Gave me the opportunity to remove these nails from my feet. It hurts like a motherfucker. Now listen up. Vic the Patriarch's son is in the Patriarch's wing, doing God knows what. Rangers, I can't say this enough. As bad as his guys are, Vic is worse. Much worse. I heard Ash. It's one of Vic's inner circle, saying he had the key to the Patriarch's wing. He's in some kind of security control room, not far down the hall. More importantly, Vic has hostages. Killed most of them, but two from my team are being tortured, and so are three from the 100 families. I don't know their exact locations, but I strongly suggest you try to find those five hostages before taking on Vic himself. Sure. I know they took Bezzeppi to a science lab. They have her working with someone named The Gift. It sounds like that big brain of hers is keeping her safe. I have no idea where they took Laloka and Rook. The guards in the lobby kept joking about how lucky I was compared to what Vic was planning for the two of them. I really hope they're okay. What a fucking mess. Part of the Ward family, and two sisters, part of the Reed family. Can't really say much more. Even before the nails, they kept me locked down. The breathers, they never talked to me, but they look tough. I'm not sure what they want, or why they're working for Vic. Good luck, Rangers. We're counting on you.
Hello again, Rangers. What can I do for you? Yeah.
Fuck it! Ugh.
Lovely old portrait. This is... What kind of sick person would do this?
Everyone calm down! This childish hysteria is beneath you! You're members of the 100 families, for God's sake! Act like it! These are bandit scum! nothing more. I don't know how they managed to get up here, but there's no chance they'll make it inside. We're protected by the best guards money can buy. Don't worry. That was one of ours. Bandits don't carry rocket launchers. Nobody panic. The guards must have shut off the power as a safety precaution. Everything is going to be fine.
You're the Rangers. I knew you'd be coming to save us. I never gave up hope. As you can see, Rangers, I've been stabbed, just like the others. But I held on, played dead, and when none of them were looking, I swallowed the key, Rangers. Key to the treasury door, Rangers. Heavily armored, can't be breached. The treasure of the 100 families is safe as long as Llewellyn is around. Ugh. Maybe this is too much to ask, but do any of you happen to be a doctor? I'm not feeling so good. Oh, feels much better, Rangers. Much better. I feel good enough to sprint all the way back to Colorado Springs. Well, maybe in a little bit. Oh, I see. You want to make sure everything's secure. Not to worry, Rangers. It's right here, in my belly. And nobody's getting their hands on it. It's good and stuck in there. Mark my words. Nope, the door only has one key and I ate it. And if someone wants it, why they had to cut it out of me. Right, I'll lay low.
You're fade.
Right.
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 luck, strangers. You're gonna see some bad shit here. And honestly, it's not for everyone. I've cooked some of Daddy's friends, thrown them off things, tried peeling a guy's eye. Didn't work!
Boys, and...
It's okay, Pris. You can do this. There's no point in both of us dying. Just close your eyes and run.
I can't do it, Violet! I really can't do that to my sister!
You have to, Pris. Do it! No, wait! Who is that? You! You're not with them! Help us, please! Vic Buchanan forced us to stand on pressure plates. If one of us steps off, it'll blow up the other. One of us has to make a run for it and kill the other. Eventually, we'll be too tired to stand and we'll both die. We can't even take a step. I think maybe the trap can be disabled with that box over on the wall there, but we can't reach it.
Ladies, it's me, Lucia, remember? We'll find a way to get you out of there, I promise.
Lucy? But you look so...
cool. Look at her, Violet. She's got scars now. She's a proper wasteland warrior.
Take a look at the electrical box. There must be something you can do there.
Amazing! You just reached in there and fixed stuff!
Why didn't we just pull the wires coming from the box?
Wouldn't be that easy, ladies. Stuff like that only works in stories.
Oh, and, Lucia... I'm sorry about Isaac. He's an idiot.
I know.
Away, I suppose. We'll run back to Colorado Springs, if we have to. Our mother is here, too. She's in the Patriarch's Wing with Victory. She's not pleasant, and she doesn't much care for us, but if you can, please help her.
Finally fucking made it, huh? Finally found the time? Assholes. Yeah, I guess the mission comes first. Fucking assholes. This shit's my fault, not yours. Couldn't keep my mouth shut. Never could stand bullies, and this place is fucking full of them. Anyway, you came for me, and I won't forget that. I guess you took out the guards. Bastards ain't so tough now. Patriarch's Wing. They dragged me in there a bunch of times for my hourly beatings. I didn't mind much. better scenery. Gonna be hard for you to get inside. Heavy security door. Also, I'm pretty sure they're holding the leader of one of those ruling families in there, so, take it slow and check your targets. Hands off. I'm fine.
Thanks. Thought I was done there for a sec.
Much obliged.
Outside the door. Hello. My name's Ash. I guess I shouldn't tell you that. Anyway, Vic says you can't come in here. Well, this is where all the security systems are. I guess I shouldn't have told you that either. But what the heck? When I said you can't come in, I meant that I got a kill switch in here. Yeah, if you barge in, I gotta kill all the hostages. I'm, sorry about that, but that's what Vic told me to do. Yeah, I know, but you know how, like, you end up stuck in a bad situation, and the only way out is to keep doing the stuff you don't wanna? This is one of those things. Okay, see you.
No. Okay. I surrender, I guess. For what it's worth, I'm sorry about the hostages. But I warned you not to come inside, or I'd have to press the button. In my defense, I told you it was Vic's orders. I didn't want to kill anyone. But I can help you now that you're here, right? I can give you the key to Vic's place. Yeah, you could definitely do that. But I'm trying to surrender and, like, you gotta let me, right?
I remember Victory's boys. This one's harmless compared to them. And he's nothing next to Vic himself.
Wow. I was like mega sure I was dead there. You're good people. I mean that. Ow. I was supposed to check in with our guys and keep Vic informed about the prisoners. You know, let Vic know which torture methods were working well and which weren't. Yes? But that wasn't my fault. Vic told them to do it, and it's not like I could stop them if I wanted to. Sure thing, boss. What do you want to know? Well, he's pretty tough and good with bombs and guns. I've known him a long time, and he ain't afraid of much, but he does a lot of drugs, a ton of drugs, and he likes to lock himself up to be alone when he does, like now. Oh, well, he wants to take over Colorado Springs. Everyone knows that. Ain't even a secret. He's gonna take his army, that's us, and the breathers, and we're gonna storm the walls, maybe attack it from within. It kinda depends on Vic's mood. Oh, yeah, or like blow up generators and attack the walls. I ain't sure. Like I said, Vic's still thinking things through. All the plans basically have us sabotaging stuff while the breathers take on the Patriarch's marshals. Like as cannon fodder, you know? That way we don't get hurt. Oh, I probably shouldn't have said that last part. It was told to me in confidence. Don't tell the breathers I said anything. Vic wants to use the breather gases on the people in Colorado Springs. Like, to make them calm? Compliant? Vic's been having the guys run experiments on the captives. And that's all, okay? That's all I know. Please keep all that to yourself. I don't want to get in trouble. Not much, boss. I mean, the hostages were spread all over this place, and we dumped the people Vic killed in the storage room. Vic's in his dad's old suite. He's got some of his tougher friends in there. The ones who always pick on me, you know? As for your ranger friends, let's see. Two of them were being tortured, but I don't know where Vic put them. You probably already saw the radio guy, Woody or whatever. And the green chick is in the lab with Gift. That's the breather lady. Oh, I came up with it myself. I had a dream once about how ash, like the nuclear ash, was falling from the sky, and it's sort of become my philosophy-like. I think the ash is gonna fall again like the final deluge religion says, and like, kill us all? So there's no real point in worrying about it.
That is not at all what the deluge is about.
Hey, it's just what I believe, that's all. I ain't saying you're wrong, and you can't say I'm wrong. You got it, boss. I'll just stay right here.
On the hostages.
I see. So you were able to save some of the hostages. Great job. Can't always save everyone, Rangers. I'm sure you did your best. There's only one thing left for you to do now. Go take care of business with Victory Buchanan.
Eyes sharp, Rangers.
I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me skin you and scalp you with a razor. A dirty, rusty razor. You made me happy sometimes. You made me glad. But in the end, baby, you just made me mad.
They look like you, sound like you. Do you know them?
Yes, Gift. I know them. They don't want to hurt anyone. They want to help.
Is that so? So, Rangers, you've killed many of my breathers on your way here. You want to help? Let's start by ending the killing, then. My breathers don't live in the same reality you do, Rangers. They move in and out of the dream. Victory guides them, and he guided them to kill intruders. So, introductions? I am the Gift. I make the gases that enable my breathers to live in the dream. But it was Victory that first showed us the dream. It is his guidance that shows us the path through it. But I do not approve of all this killing. Why bring death into the dream? And not all you outsiders are that bad. Pazeppi here has been a real help. So, let's talk, yes? Ah. Implied violence. Your friend will stay with us to ensure everyone stays on their best behavior. So, you must have questions. Talk then. More fighting. More death? Why, Victory? This will only lose minds from the dream. Worse still, my work is not for the uninitiated. The dream will destroy their minds. I know, I know. Deal with him as you like. We will not interfere. The breathers will travel their own path now, without Victory. Go if you want. Can still use you. But go if you want.
Thank you, Gift. Rangers, let's talk. Outside.
But be warned. Other than my guards, the breathers inside this lodge are too far gone into the dream for me to reach. Avoid them if you can. Kill them if you must. Yes, it is. My mother. My sister. Me. This was before. Don't remember this place. Too long ago. But this was her home. The girl I was. The girl that broke. The girl Victory healed. A kindness. But escape from what? Victory found me when I was broken, shaped me into what I am now. It is where I should be. I am the Gift because of what I bring into the world. Access to the dream. Victory showed me this. He showed us all. Yes. Victory Buchanan gave it to me. Strong. Reliable. It lets me move. Broken as I am. Once. Yes. Your curiosity speaks well of you. Ask. Distressing. There is no violence in the dream. But when they're in there, they're pliable, suggestible, like children. I have always trusted Victory to guide them well. This? No. I need to remain in reality to guide others into the dream. This is for the pain. Yes, let's.
Goodness. Rangers! We thought we were the only ones who survived the ambush on the lake.
When we got captured, I was absolutely sure the mission was dead. This is such good news! Go team! We have common interests. At first, I thought she was going to cut me open, but after they gassed me to keep me compliant and it didn't work, we talked about chemistry all night. It was practically a slumber party. Well, you know, it's hard to leave anywhere once you get comfortable, so to speak. I heard you rescued Rook. Good job. I'm still worried about La Loca. She doesn't back down and is crazy enough to get herself killed. Or did something happen to her? For the love of all that is good and decent. I see why this place is called Little Hell. And Woodson, have you found him yet? Please don't tell me him too. This place, this damn place. Sorry, language. Vic is in the Patriarch's wing, the fancy one. The prisoners are all somewhere else. I don't know. I heard a guard talking about chemical testing being done on a man in the sauna. There were 5 hostages left, apart from Woodson and me. I was separated from them when the gift requested that I remain by her side. The other 2 hostages were women, and they were part of the 100 families. I'm not sure where they were taken. I'm sure you could, truth be told. What I need right now is a breather. This place really was hell, and I need to gather my wits. But I'll be rooting for you. And let's talk once you're done here, yeah? Now, where did I put the rest?
Coming after me, strangers. My father's the real monster. Him and Libby. At least I'm wrong in the obvious places. You can trust my kind of crazy.
real.
That's over. These combats are killing me.
revive the gas?
Not a chance.
Thank you.
Back.
This room must control the airflow to the sauna.
Yeah.
barrier positioning!
Beat on them. And
Did you just kill my personal guard? They were my best friends from fucking childhood, man. Holy shit. I can't remember the names.
That'll do nicely. Thanks. Gwendolyn Reed. She's head of the Reed family, and my ex-boyfriend's mother. She's terrible. To everyone.
You're not one of Victory's thugs. They at least look dangerous. Ah. You're the Rangers that Saul Buchanan sent for. Months ago, if I recall. Where are my daughters? Are they safe? I don't recall asking for excuses. I asked if my daughters are safe. Victory had me sitting here for days, threatening to fill those empty chairs with my headless daughters, while you frolicked in the snow. I will have words with Saul Buchanan about the punctuality of his servants. Make no mistake. Now go take care of his infantile son, if you can even manage that.
Enough to get here.
Rangers, let's not waste time talking. We should put this monster down.
Play it safe, Rangers. We want him alive.
Yeah, come on in. Let's have some fun, huh?
Wow. Hey, look who it is, Clarence.
Rangers.
In the flesh.
The Rangers? I heard they were a bunch of little fucking chicken shits.
I know it was hard to get here, and no offense, but you can fuck right off back to Colorado Springs and tell Daddy you failed.
I like it here.
Rangers, I have to level with you. That sounds fucking boring. Why would I do that?
Well, I'll have to give them a little pep talk about loyalty. Or take a shit in their oxygen tanks, undecided. But I'm not worried, as long as I got my buddy Clarence here.
Clarence? Clarence! Oh, no! Oh, Clarence! He was 2 days away from retirement!
That's just me then, huh? Fine. You got me, Rangers. Now what?
Oh, That it? Sure thing, officers. Oh, but hold on. Before you slap the cuffs on, I have a... what's the word? A proposition for you. Don't lock me up. Take me with you. And I'll give you the VIP tour of Daddy's Kingdom. Everyone here knows me. Everyone's fucking terrified of me. And that means they'll be terrified of you. At least I tried. Take me away from all this, officer.
Copy, November 1. This is Ranger HQ. Go ahead. Hell yeah, November. I'll sleep much better at night knowing he's behind bars. Over and out.
There you are, Rangers. Starting to wonder if Vic got you.
Good to see you getting shit done, November.
I'll radio HQ and get them to send us some transport. See you there.
Before you head out, I have something to ask you. If I go back to Ranger HQ now, I'll probably end up in a room doing lab work. I'd rather take my chances out there with you. There are some things you just can't learn in the lab, you know? So, can I join your squad? Glad to join your team.
HQ calling Team November. Got a lady here says she's a Desert Ranger, part of Angela Death's advance team, with an important message. Gonna hold her here till you get back. Copy. Well, as far as I could tell, she's the real deal. Showed us her Ranger star and everything. We're making her comfortable in the war room. She'll be here when you get back. Affirmative, Rangers. And before I forget, the guys and gals in R&D have put together some new tech. You should head back to HQ and see for yourselves. Over and out. Copy, November 1. Toes on the way.
You ever want a wrench full time? I know a dozen Arapaho garages who'd be proud to have you.
I thought you had to be Arapaho to work for the tribe.
Well, mostly, but they'll make exceptions for exceptional talent. And you got it.
Well, I appreciate the suggestion, but as soon as the Rangers finish this job for the patriarch, I'm heading back to Arizona and my family. Things are tough there right now, and there's a lot to do.
Finally, we have enough parts to finish the repairs on the Superhead.
Great! What's the Superhead?
Not Superhead. Superhead. The Superhead for Dyne Receiver. This'll allow us to clean up and amplify our received transmissions more effectively. Precisely. The trick will be matching impedances and Q factors along the way, since we aren't able to find any transistors of spec. Welcome to your communications. From here on out, I will be your voice in the wind. You can contact Ranger HQ at any time through your radio, and I'll reach out as needed. Anytime.
Sato is my hero. Never eaten this well in my life.
I need some help! Here, expect you to find
so, the machines at the airport decided you were okay. What kind of rain? Probably just buying the Monster Army time. Someone's gonna take the bazaar from them sooner or later.
There's some. I'm gonna try to convince you to flip the tables and rebuild Colorado. And they're even. So. Hey, remember that dancer in Vegas? Rain Tree Roxy?
Oh, do I? And how?
Oh, what a lump. Yeah.
She used to dance a little on her left leg.
Then she danced a little on
her
right.
Looks like we ain't dying here after all.
Between the two of them, she made a living.
Hey! Marry that girl.
Oh, my head. Need a little painkiller to take the edge off.
Poor Scotchmo. You know, if we ever get back to Arizona, my people possess a cure for your condition.
We need a fourth for Pinochle.
My...
Me?
What'd you say?
Yeah, I do, actually. You really want to
You have a disease.
Yeah, why not?
But the scientists of Darwin have developed...
Right now, so...
Sure. Okay, I'm in.
Great. A little drink won't fix.
Aw, oh, Scotchmo.
Psycho! Oh, come on! It itches so bad! No! You'll just grab me and try to choke me again!
Now, what do you mean, again?
I was just giving you a hug last time. And why do I still have bruises on my neck?
Lexicranium! You'd already stutter! Oh, I'm so proud of you.
Talking about trash.
It's speech impediment. It's gone. How did you do it?
I've never had a speech impediment. You're confusing me with somebody else.
Ah, come on, Lex. I know.
And then Wickman told the guy, if you can find your ass with both hands, we'll let you go.
Good work bringing in victory. Patriarch will be pleased.
Yes.
Lieutenant Train Zhang, Rangers. I've brought a message from Angela Death. Yep. I bet we just miss each other back home. My husband Jason and I left California with Colonel Death when she returned to AZ. Jason opened his gun shop at HQ and I signed on. Then Angela picked me for the Colorado Advance Team and I've been here ever since. Missing Jason like crazy, but that's the life of a ranger, right? Colonel Death has info for you that's too sensitive for the airwaves. She wants a face-to-face. Sent me to arrange it. She doesn't have much reason to trust you, does she? Despite her showing you the Patriarch's bad side, you're still following his orders. She's not going to put her head in the lion's mouth. If you want to meet her, it'll have to be on neutral ground. The House of the Hoon family. Just your squad. Nobody else. Will you come? Thanks, Rangers. I'll be here until you get back.
Team November, we've got trouble. Scar collectors are attacking the perimeter at multiple points. We're coordinating the defense now, but we need all hands on deck.
Will do.
Out there.
Rangers! Come out and play! Liberty says thanks for dealing with her brothers. Now, deal with this. Order! Get me now, fucker! Got my sights on their flanks!
taking their six.
Get ready. get me now, fucker! To detect the perks!
Taking cover!
Taking the shot!
Moving to safety!
What are you doing? The occupants of Colorado Springs are under our protection.
Burning!
You're testing me, Rangers. Harm a non-combatant in Colorado Springs, and I'm done with you. And the Patriarch will be too.
suspects are still resisting!
Taking the shot!
Move it up! Moving to flank!
The Patriarch invited you here to help Colorado Springs. I'm done with you.
No!
You have gone beyond the pale, Rangers. That person was no threat to you. I'm leaving. You disgust me.
Kills me.
Brain Liberty Sound! Now, deal with this! Blurs Party!
Coming in from their side!
Can't get me now, fucker! Forward to death!
Pushing forward!
out!
Moving to
safety!
Shit just got real.
Get me now, fucker!
No one can stop the Rangers.
Taking the shot! Taking their six!
Taking the shot!
never truly die. Trap set!
Taking the high advantage!
Somebody call the marshals!
Moving to flank!
Can't keep me down!
There has been a reckoning.
We got this, Ranger!
Moving to flight!
Taking the pain!
No.
Taking their six!
firing!
That's over. These combats are...
Oh!